Hello everyone, welcome to today's movie world. I'm the scientific movie critic, Wong Ray. You can call me Ray, Lovely Ray, or Cute Ray. Okay, let's start. The movie we appreciate today is WALL-E. Yes, it doesn't sound like as cool as Star Trek, and also there is no professional physical name like Gravity. So why would I choose it?First, because the entire story covers concerns about environmental issues, and nowadays, fewer modern societies are left untouched by a variety of environmental problems. The second reason is the movie can make people rethink about how to develop and utilize artificial intelligence rationally. This is a hot field of current scientific research. Okay, get to the point.Let me introduce the movie itself to you. The story happens in a very far, far future. At that time, the human moved from the Earth into a huge spaceship because our Earth is full of rubbish. They leave a rubbish collection robot called WALL-E on the Earth. 700 later, he get a visitor.A beautiful robot called Eva is sent to the Earth by humans in order to find the plant. Then, they take a very attractive adventure across the galaxy together. Can you imagine? Still want me to continue? Don't worry, let's get to know the main characters first. The first one is the pure, kind, persistent, timid WALL-E.While the second is an alert, agile, daring Eva. Next, a capital who is lazy, brave, full of yearning for the Earth. Finally, a caution, calm, mechanical auto. The film uses the conflict between humans and these robots as a clue to promote the plots. Beyond the basics, we will get to the best part.The physics or scientists' problems in the movie and their real-life applications. Since the limited time, we will elaborate three parts. Friction, Newton's law of motion, and artificial intelligence knowledge. Can't wait, right? Get all the movie elements ready. Let's start our wonderful analysis with a short video.From the movie, we can see that WALL-E can stand on the slope without falling down. If the slope is smooth, then WALL-E is subjected to a vertical downward gravity and a supporting force perpendicular to the oblique surface. The gravity can break down into a force perpendicular to the slope direction and a force parallel to the slope.The force perpendicular to the slope direction and the supporting force from the slope are a pair of balancing force. However, no force can offset the force parallel to the slope. At this time, the object cannot be stationary on the surface. It is precisely because it's also subject to the friction force along the oblique surface,so that the two opposite forces along the surface become a pair of balancing forces, and thus, WALL-E is subject to the force balance stator. After understanding the effects of friction, here comes a problem. What facts will affect the friction? Let me reveal the secret.The amount of friction is related to the pressure between the surface. When the roughness of the surface is constant, the greater the pressure, the greater the friction. It's also related to the roughness of the surface. When the pressure is constant, the rougher the surface, the greater the friction. Okay, after understanding this, how can we apply this to real life? Let me give you some more practical tips.Such as how to have more chance to win a tug of war. First, wear shoes with concave and convex soles. which can increase the friction coefficient and finally increase the friction. Second, you can be a heavyweight if you want to be a good tug of war player, because the heavier the weight of the player, the greater the pressure on the ground and thus increase the friction. After finish this part, let's follow Newton into his world. Hi friends, let me start my part with a short video. In the movie, we see that when the spaceship wants to go back up into space, it starts at rest and then it hits fuel down in order to make it go up. It contains my three laws of motion. My first law is also called the law of inertia. You see that the spaceship at rest tends to at rest unless there are some force to change its motion state. It means objects at equilibrium will not accelerate. It will only accelerate if there is a net or unbalanced force acting upon it. In the real life, seat belt is a good application. The force of the road on the locked wheel provides the unbalanced force to changing the car's state of motion. Yet, there is no unbalanced force to change in your own state of motion. Thus, you continue in motion. So, why can't you stop? Because the balanced force of a seat belt. Well, that's all for my first law. Now, let me go into introduce the second law. The chemical used in the making of the fire to generate the thrust F. Assume the mass of the spaceship is m, then the acceleration of this motion is f divided by m, and the direction of acceleration is the same as the direction of the force. If we want to generate large acceleration, then we should either increase thrust or decrease the mass of the spaceship. Since great force, same mass, the great acceleration. Same force, great mass, the less acceleration. Come back. When you ride a bicycle, have you ever experienced the second law? If you want to be faster, you just have to push the pedal harder. If you only use a little effort, you are probably as slow as a snail. At the same time, you will feel more tired when you ride a bike to take a person, because now the greater the total mass of two people. In order to achieve the same acceleration, you need to use more force. Alright, next is my last law of motion. In a spaceship, burning fuel creates a push on the front of the rocket and pushing it forward. This creates an equal and opposite push on the gas backwards. In addition, there is another thing in the movie that embodies this law. Let's enjoy it together.
Wally!
Thank you.
When Wally wants to fly forward, he took the eject and pumped it backwards. It creates an equal and opposite reaction force that allowed him to move forward. After knowing the principle, do you want to know the property of it? Haha, let me explain it to you one by one. First, mutuality, that is, the two are always mutual.Appearing in pairs. Second, allergeneic, that is, the two interact on two different objects that interact with each other, which is the most important and most obvious differences between it and a pair of balancing force. Third, simultaneous, that is, both are produced simultaneous changing and disappearing at the same time. So now,I finished my part. Let's welcome Ray to take you into the next scientific world. Bye-bye! Hello, my dear friends. I'm back. So, I'm going to take you into the artificial intelligence world now. Let's take a look at first.
Lots of worlds. Oh, hands on deck!
Morning. Just a tram?
Uh-huh. Oh, I see. I know, honey, I know. I am good. You look gorgeous.
Coffee.Protocol, Otto. First things first. Computer, status report. Mechanical systems?
Unchanged.
Reactor core temperature?
Unchanged.
Passenger count?
Unchanged.
Regenerative food buffet?
Unchanged.
Jacuzzi pH balance?
Unchanged.
Atmospheric conditions? Unchanged. County service volume?
Unchanged.
Okay, Otto.
It's a great life, isn't it?Artificial intelligence is the theory and the development of computer systems. It is able to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence. There are many artificial intelligence technologies related to these things, such as image recognition. It is the process of identifying and detecting an object or feature in a digital image or video.Text analytics, to understand the structure of sentence, as well as their meaning and intention. Robotic process automation, to use script and the methods that mimic and automate human tasks to support work process. Sounds high level, right? But in fact, we have already been exposed to this artificial intelligence in real life, such as Siri,Have you ever asked Siri who is the cutest and most intelligent people in the world? Anyway, I always do that. Besides this, Cortana, Google Now, the logistic robot used by Alibaba, all these greatly facilitate human life. However, every coin has two sides. The form also depicts concerns about the use of artificial intelligence.Let's have a look together.
Hey, drink some water. Here, take the cup. Hey, take the cup.
Please remain stationary. A service bot will be here to assist you momentarily.
Stewards? Hello?
Please remain stationary. A service bot will be here to assist you momentarily.
What's that? What's going on?
Wow. Yes, excessive reliance on artificial intelligence. People's body become obese. Their actions become dull, and even simple behaviors such as climbing up from the ground can't be complete. Are you scared? Terrible. Not just this.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We're having a slight malfunction with the autopilot. Please remain calm.
Although the robots in the movie seem to serve humans on the surface, they still have the ambitions to betray human beings. Once they act, they pose a great threat to the normal life order of human beings and even the safety of life. Human beings become weak and helpless in front of robots designed and developed by themselves. What a horrible and sad thing it is. Okay, our rational analysis of physics ends here. Next is our live audience connection part. Friends who have seen this movie, what can you learn from it? Hurry up, call and share with us. The first caller. Hello.
Hello, Ray. I think the environmental protection is so important. I don't want the earth become dumb and not suitable for humans to live anymore.
Yes, when I saw these things, I was also afraid of that.
The second caller.
Hello.
Hi, Ray. I think people should rationally develop and apply the artificial intelligence. Both its advantages and disadvantages should not be ignored.
All right. I totally agree with you. Besides this, I also think we should appreciate contributions of scientific workers to our world. Yes, not only the famous scientists, but also those silently dedicated people, such as experiments, our lectures, and so on. They all contribute to the development of science. Let me bow to them here. Well, that's the end of today's program. In a word, WALL-E is worth watching. If you are interested, try to look for it. Thank you very much. See you next time.